Kylo Ren yanked off his mask to get some fresh air. He was an idiot. His stomach roiled with this inevitable certainty as he gingerly stepped around the burning wreckage of his tie. She had run like a frightened womp rat, and in his blind rage, he had succumbed to the temptation, not pausing to consider that maybe she had a plan. With this realization came another certainty, even more gut-wrenching. He was relieved he hadn't killed her. Snoke had always encouraged him to pursue his impulses. They were a shortcut to the dark side and unimaginable power. But his impulse to kill Rey had almost ruined everything he'd been planning. Kylo didn't know how to reconcile that. The path to the dark side lay in succumbing to one's desires. But his deepest desire, the thing he wanted most, would require planning and patience. The Emperor had figured out how to embrace a plan so long-suffering and painstakingly careful it boggled the mind. And he did it without being tempted by the light even a little. There was a way. He just had to learn it. Kylo sensed a tug in the Force as he stepped from billowing smoke into clear air. Far away, Rey stood in the sand, straining, her arm reaching toward a flying transport. And she was succeeding in slowing it down. It didn't matter what or who was inside that transport that made Rey desperate to prevent its escape. He was not going to let her have it. He reached out, felt the massive machinery in his mind, yanked it toward himself. The transport almost jerked out of her grip, and she gasped at the familiar presence. Kylo, alive and well. Rey would not let him have Chewie. Chewie was hers. She strained to regain control, and she felt the ship lurch in her direction. But then it whipped right back. Rey tried to remember her training.
Let the Force guide your actions,
Leia would say. But thinking of Leia, her training, even for the briefest moment, made her lose concentration, and the ship listed again in Kylo's direction. So Rey bore down with all the strength of her being. Blood screamed in her ears, and her heart was a massive drum in her chest. She drew on her rage at Kylo, at the First Order, even at Unkar Plutt. She drew on her terror for Chewie's life, remembered what it felt like to watch Han Solo drop into the abyss at Starkiller Base. She drew on pain, too. The aching hollowness of an empty stomach. The bruised knuckles with no Bacta to soothe them. The feel of grit in her molars after a windy day. The dagger-sharp silence of loneliness. Rey opened her mouth in a silent scream. Raw power burst from her fingertips, arced toward the freighter. It was blue lightning, pure Force energy, brighter than a lightsaber, hotter than a sun. It wrapped its deadly, crooked fingers around the transport, which jerked sideways for the briefest instant, and then exploded into a sickening fireball. Rey stumbled back, gasping for air, as bits of wreckage rained down onto the desert plain. The transport and everyone inside reduced to nothingness. She stared down at her hand in horror, then at the bits of wreckage. Her stomach heaved. And finally, she screamed. As tears poured down her cheeks, what had she done? A voice penetrated her haze of guilt madness. It was Poe calling to her.
We gotta go! They're coming! Ray, come on!
He pointed toward the horizon, and she turned. Half a dozen First Order TIEs were quickly approaching.
We gotta go!
Run, Kelly!
I'm sorry, Poe yelled. But we have to go! Now!
Ray, come on!
His voice, along with Finn's rapid approach, convinced her feet to move. She would not lose any more friends. She hurried toward Finn, and together they ran for the ship. From a distance, Kylo Ren watched the freighter rise into the sky, Rey inside it. She had beaten him again. And yet, he was filled with triumph. He'd been right to push her. She had just demonstrated unbelievable, mind-blowing power. Dark power. Sith power. The scavenger was almost ready to turn. And when she did, they would both kill their light, embrace their darkness. Then the Star Destroyer fleet and the Sith throne would be theirs.